my creatives and welcome to another video. So today I'm going to make a pocket letter with you, and this pocket letter is for my dear friend Shay from the Sleepless Planner. I will also leave her social media links down below. She's a wonderful, wonderful person. I'm so lucky to have met her here on YouTube. So I will leave her YouTube channel and her Instagram down below for you to check out. But first of all, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. So I'm going to cut up some pattern paper and for my pocket letter. And the size of the cards are 3.5 inch by 2.5 inch. And I need 9 pieces of pattern paper. So what I'm using today is the All Heart collection from Crate Paper. But this is the digital kit that I bought at AC Digitals. So I like to repeat some patterns, but there's also always one that is also always different, and that's the middle one. But I really liked these pattern papers, and they reminded me of Shay because there's a lot of positive affirmations in there, but also you know, like things like ugh. So I really wanted to make a pocket letter with this collection for her. So what I'm doing here is I'm going to do my first round of embellishing, and I do this in multiple rounds, so I have an idea of how I want it to be. I also see this pocket letter as a whole. I don't see this as separate cards because I want somewhat of a balanced look in my pocket letter, and I don't want the cards to be separate or that you can see that they don't belong next to each other. So I am just going through these embellishments, and these are all hand cut because it is a digital kit and I printed at home. I have to fuzzy cut them myself, which I don't mind because I love to do that on the couch when I want to be a bit creative but not really have any motivation or I'm not feeling it. I just like to cut up kits. I will also make a video soon about how I prepare and print my kits, but that I have to do some technical things and I have to figure that out first before I can show you that. But don't worry, that video will come because I really want to share with you how I do this, and it was also a request, so of course I want to share that with you. So yeah, I'm just going through these embellishments for my first round of embellishing, and you see these two cards, I don't really know what to do with them. This piece is actually a little card from a cut apart sheet officially, I think, but I just chose to fussy cut her the two fingers out, or the peace sign. So now I'm going in with some washi. And I really like that this washi has a translucent background so you can see the pattern paper behind it. And I will start assembling my cards. So I also take a Staedtler pigment liner and I'm going to do doodly border around all the cards. Of course, because I love to do that. And with the washi tape, I keep in mind that this is a bit all over the pocket letter so that this connects some of the cards together. And now I'm just going to stick them down. You see me fuss around with my glue roller because the tape broke, but there's still lots of glue on there. So I am using it, of course, but it's a bit messy. But that's okay. It glues fantastically. Only I have to take the tape out. Usually the dispenser does it by itself, but now I have to do it by hand, which is sometimes a bit. But you know, I don't want to throw away glue that is still perfectly usable just because the tape broke. Yeah, now I'm going to take another piece of washi strip that was in the collection, and I'm just going to assemble things that I know I want to have on there. So I chose to do a pocket letter with words like be you and here comes the fun and all those kinds of things because I think Shay, you needed a little pick-me-up. I sent this to her when COVID-19 hit first. So I thought we all could use a little pick-me-up. So that's why I chose to make this for her. And I'm just going to yeah, stick these embellishments down. So if you want to know what I used, all of the supplies that I use are listed down below, and some of them are linked down below, some of them are affiliate links and some of them are not. But if I can find it online or on Amazon, you will find a link down below so you can check it out for yourself what I used. So now I'm going to work on the card with the tag, and I also like to use doilies. And I have these very, very small, tiny doilies, and they are perfect for a pocket letter. So I'm just going to put this on the corner here, and I will keep the remaining part and will add it somewhere else to bring back the doily somewhere else on my pocket letter. I like to repeat elements so that it is more cohesive. It's the same with the doodly border. I repeat it on all the cards so they all fit together. Now I'm going to take some twine and I'm going to thread that through the hole, and I like to I don't know how you say that, fold it four times and thread it through so that you have a beautiful, more like fuller tassel and not just two strings hanging there. I like it when there is a bit more twine in the hole and you can really see it and not just two tassels just like hanging there. So yeah, that is what I'm going to do, and I will come back to you once I have something more to say. So now I am going to take some thickers because I really like to include the name of the person that I'm sending it to. So I was a bit in doubt on which card I wanted to place it. So I first thought I wanted to place it on this card, but I didn't like the way it looked with the U. So I tried on this card, but I also really didn't like that. And I'm going to take that off again because I thought the image was covered up too much. And now I decide on putting it on the record player because I like the contrast of it, and you could still see the record player and her name without the image being too much covered up. Because these are small cards, so you really have to think about not going too big, which is sometimes really hard. So here's another positive affirmation or something I wanted to say to her. I really wanted to say to her, girl, you totally got this. You are a champ. You can do this. You are amazing. You got this. And that is what I really wanted to send her with this pocket letter. So you saw me taking another embellishment, and I'm going through my second round of embellishing right now. As you see, there are two cards I still don't know what to do with, so I'm going through all the things that I have, and I'm going to figure out if there's something that will fit the theme or fit the style that I'm working with. And I just lay them there first and see the overall look before I commit and stick something down. But like I said, I do this in steps, and that is more approachable for me if I do it in steps and not completely at once. So I'm sorry that the top part isn't in screen fully. I will come back and you will see everything that I do. But yeah, sometimes I forget that I'm filming and I'm just playing around with my embellishments. So sometimes things aren't completely in screen. You see the card with the lipstick that has lipstick on there right now. That's the card I struggled with. There's always one card that is like, I don't know what to do with this card. So I have put Radiate Positivity there, but okay, so I'm gonna say it's like this. You don't always have to be positive. And I don't like the fact that positive thinking and positivity is so you have to be this always, even when things are hard. Some days you are just not, and that is okay. If your overall mindset is positive, that's okay, but you can have days where you just don't think like that. That's okay. So I didn't want to put it on there because it felt like, I don't know, like she had to be positive, and that was not the goal that I was going for. I wanted just to send her a little bit of support and a little bit of faith and trust and belief in her. So I didn't think the radiate positivity was suitable for the message that I wanted to send. So now we go to this card, and because I saw the whole pocket letter, I figured out what I wanted to do. And I'm going to take this little Polaroid that says I love you, because I love her. She's an amazing person. And I'm going to add the girl in there and a flower, and I'm going to layer those pieces up. So I think the most important thing is when you do pocket letters or journal pages or anything, is to layer your embellishments and also cover them up a little bit. You don't have to show the whole thing. It's not necessary. To give the effect, and it looks much more cohesive and pretty if you layer them a little bit. Of course, you want certain items to show, but you don't have to show the whole thing to make it look pretty. So now I'm going in for the card that I really struggled with, because I really wanted to show the pattern and I wanted to add things, but I wasn't quite sure. I wanted to add the lipstick because I really liked it, and then I find little pieces that I wanted to add on other cards. But yeah, that's just how it goes, because I see this pocket letter as a whole, and I really recommend you do so, to see it as a whole and not as individual cards, because that way you will have a balanced look and it will look cohesive. So I'm going through this embellishment tray that I have, and I am going in for some smaller pieces now, like this roller skate. I really love that, and sometimes it just looks like it belongs there, so I'm just going to stick that down. And I end up adding a tiny word. I can't read right now what it says. I think feeling it. End up putting that there, and then I go back into the card that is really difficult for me. So you see me here go through the embellishments and just sitting there, and I'm like, I don't know. I really like the girl power. I like the font, and I like the tone of the pink. And yeah, I'm just a bit struggling, guys. So yeah, off to the side, just out of screen, I have a bunch of die cuts laying around that I thought I could include in the pocket letter or use, but you don't see them right now. You will see them later on when I add the goodies. So now I'm just going to commit. This was a point I'm like, this is pretty okay. Let's just go for it. I'm stopping the fussing, because you have to have a point where you just stop and put down what you have there. And that is what I did here. In the end, the card looks okay. It's not my favorite, but I am happy with the cluster that I made, and it was good enough. You don't always have to create masterpieces, especially these are 9 cards, and you don't always like all of your cards. They're not all gonna be your favorites. So to give a little bit of extra punch, I'm going to add a doodly border around the words, and I think that made it complete for me. So the next step is for me to add some gems or self-adhesive pearls, and I'm just going to scatter them around all my cards. So I'm taking some gold ones on this flower floral pattern, because I thought the contrast looked really nice together and it brought a bit of the warmth in there. And I'm going to take some silver ones, and I'm also going to add them on certain cards. Like these pink ones, because they stood out from it and it looked nice with the lipstick. But I like to repeat those on the same pattern. So I did struggle sometimes with getting them off the sheet, because they're so tiny, and the self-adhesive part sometimes just stays on the backing and not on the pearl. So yeah, that's sometimes a bit but it's okay. Now I'm going in for some rhinestones to add a little bit of bling and a little bit of shine to my pocket letter, but I don't want to overdo it, and I like to do it in groups of three. So as you can see here, on every card, I think I put three, and I don't think too much about the placement. I just put them there, and that's that. Sometimes I will move them a little bit because I see that I want to put them somewhere else, but I don't think too much about it. I just go for it. So then this is my pocket letter, and now I'm going to choose a pattern paper I want to use on the back. I don't do this every time because the paper is also a weight. And although it looks pretty and finished on the back, which of course I like, I rather send more goodies. So I don't do this all the time. But for this one, I thought it needed it. I'm sorry if you hear my voice change or anything. I'm a bit... I have hay fever. So, yeah. Now you see the goodies that I put on the side, and I'm going to add them into one of the pockets. So I added some of the die cuts that would fit, but I also thought maybe Shay would enjoy. And what I like to do for the goodies is that I use the same things as goodies as I also used on the pocket letter, because I really like to share that with the person that I am sending this to, and it makes it more cohesive if you use the same supplies or in the same color scheme. That's something that I really enjoy doing. You don't have to do that, you can send whatever you want, but that is what I like. I also added two washi samples for her with some florals and some pinks. I added some of these sticky flags because I know that Shay is a bullet journaler, among a lot of other things, but I thought maybe she could use something like this. So now I'm going back into the embellishment box, and I'm going to add some more that I thought she would enjoy using, like the ugh. We really, really needed an ugh this time of year. I also add some flow cards, and these are from a Dutch flow, but I chose quotes that are in English. But because she doesn't have Dutch flow, of course, I thought it would be a fun little unique thing to send. So they have some illustrations or some English quotes, but the date on top is in Dutch. So I think it's kind of fun to have this mix of my own language and her language. Now I'm going to add some of these 3D tags, but I had a little bit of difficulty with fitting them in. So I decide on putting three in that bottom part. And now I'm going in for a writing paper. So I'm auditioning a few pieces, I'm folding them up, but they don't fit in the pocket. So I go for this piece of paper that is from a flow notebook, and it's very, very thin, so it can be folded very easily. And I'm going to cut off a piece here, but I cut it completely crooked, so I will take it to my trimmer and cut off a strip so that it is kind of straight, because it was too much crookedness. I don't mind the crookedness, but this was really too much, guys. Yeah, so I'm going to fold it in a way that it will fit in the pocket. And because it is such a thin paper, it will not take up too much space. And I'm going to add that last little tag on top of it. Also going to add some washi tape over the holes. Shay can punch new holes in there if she wants to keep it in a binder, which I do. But I think it finishes it off really nice if there's just a small strip of washi. So I'm going to addition some ribbons, and in the end I'm going to decide that I didn't want to use ribbon for the closure. I wanted to do something else, but you will see that later on. There was nothing wrong with the ribbon, but it was just not... It didn't feel finished. So here is a piece of pattern paper, and I really enjoyed the look and the colors. It fit perfectly, so I thought, maybe I can make a belly band. And I am thinking about how I want to put the closure. Here I go again with the ribbon. I'm like, no ribbon. And I commit to this belly band. So I think this is the first time I did this closure. I'm not sure because I make a lot of mail, of course. I do this for years now. So I don't know if anyone remembers that I did this before. I would love to know when. Because I can't remember. But I think this is the first time that I did a closure like this. And I really enjoyed that. Because it was something a little bit different. And now it looks like a little present. I thought maybe adding a ribbon, but I decide against it. I don't know, it just didn't look right to add a ribbon to this pocket letter. So I go for doily. And doilies are always good, right? So make sure that the doily is on both sides of this belly band. So you can see it on both sides. And I'm going to add some more glue to make sure that it will not move in the mail or crumble or tear. And I'm going to do a doodly border as well on the sides where there is pattern paper. But I made sure so you can see the doodly border on the sides on the outside, so not on top. That was a weird sentence, but okay. I added my own sticker and I'm going to decorate the belly band a little bit. So I'm going to repeat the same supplies for this pocket letter. Like I said, I love to do that because it makes it more cohesive. And I'm going to take it off the pocket letter. I'm going to write "Hello, Shay." So that is also why I had to think if this would work, because I wanted to know if I would take it off, could I put it back on again? Because I know I wanted to write on it, right? So yeah, I'm going to add "Hello, Shay." And I'm going to thicken my lines a little bit so it stands out a little bit more, and I'm going to doodle in some hearts because I love this girl, she's amazing. Now I'm going to put the pocket letter back. I had to figure out a little bit how to do it, but once I figured it out, it worked perfectly. So I also wanted to send her this mixed media postcard, and I will post the process video of that soon. I still have a few of them to send out to people, but I did that with a very fun technique, so I will show you how I did that. And now I'm going to decorate the envelope. So I always first fit my mail in an envelope before I start decorating, so I have to make sure that the envelope will be properly closed, because I don't want to decorate an envelope in the style of this mail and then not be able to use this envelope because my mail is too big. So yeah, that's what I did here. When it goes to international mail, I don't really decorate the back because we have this big form that is green from our postal service that has to go on the envelope with the customs stuff, so that will take up almost all of the back. So I don't really decorate the back because yeah, that label has to go there. So here I go in with my scraps, and this is why I always recommend you keep your scraps until the end of your project. If you want to throw them away after that, that is your decision. I keep all of my scraps because I'm a hoarder. Because I kept those scraps of strips of paper, I could make the envelope look like the pocket letter because it has the same pattern papers on there, and I just put them on there as washi strips. And then I'm going to add another embellishment, and I'm going to add this camera. I thought I wanted to maybe add something else, but I'm like, no, I like the contrast of the camera. I'm going to add that on top. And then it is time for, oh yeah, another doodly border, because I also did that on the inside. So of course I had to do that on the outside, right? But that is the last thing that I do. So I write Shay her address on the front, of course. You don't see that because it is her address. I don't share that. And I always write my address on the backside. So this is the pocket letter I made for Shay. I hope you enjoyed this video. I would love it if you would give me a thumbs up. And I would also love it if you would consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you all so much for watching. And I hope to see you all next time. Bye!